Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Ball Fake Podcast. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure to like, subscribe, and support our new movement by putting Let's Go Viral in the comment section. But if you're listening on Apple Podcasts or Spotify, make sure to give us a 5-star rating and a nice review. But without further ado, here are your hosts, Nicely Chunga Benny and Greg King.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Ball Fake Podcast. Today, we're back with our Who's Better series, and we're going to be dissecting who the better individual player is between Zach LaVine and Devin Booker. But before we hop into all that, you know we got to give a quick shout out to our subscriber today, as always. And today it's going to be Garrett McGray. Thank you, bro, so much for like, comment, subscribing, and supporting our YouTube channel and our podcast overall. We greatly appreciate it. Now, Greg, let's just hop straight into this one. I don't want to waste no time. The NBA season is back. I want to be able to watch some games and everything. We obviously just finished up Halloween and all that good stuff. So it's time to get back to the grind, man. And obviously, you know, Zach LaVine and Devin Booker, one of the better scorers in the entire NBA. I mean, both of these guys have a really great reputation when it comes to, you know, just their overall offensive capabilities. But from a scoring perspective, I think I'm going to go with Zach LaVine. I mean, this is a guy that, you know, is every bit of a three-level scorer, capable of carrying the offensive load on a night-in, night-out basis, highlight reel in transition, so he's definitely going to sell tickets. And he's got the ability to be able to, you know, be an elite shot creator in a half-court setting. I mean, we saw this on display last year, specifically in isolation scenarios. I mean, this is a guy that, you know, ranked in a 92 percentile in those scenarios, put up 1.14 points per possession in those scenarios as well, and not to mention his three-point capabilities, Greg. I mean, this is a guy that, you know, shot 39% or better on catch-and-shoot threes, corner threes, above-the-break threes, and I think he shot 45% on step-back threes last year. And this is really impressive because, you know, Zach LaVine last year didn't really have too many offensive threats around him. You know, he was taking a lot of difficult shots, actually ranked in the bottom 3% last year and, you know, three-point shot quality. So with all that being said, and also tying in the fact that, you know, this is a guy that shoots 69% at the rim, I gotta say that Zach LaVine's a better scorer and shooter than a guy like Devin Booker, so to speak. But I mean, what's your opinion on that?
Yeah, I totally agree. And then on top of that, to add to your point, I mean, look who he's added. He added Lonzo Ball, who can, you know, who can pass, and so we're gonna get a more open look. So I see those percentages going up, and I predict this season that he will be a 50, 40, 90 guy. But first, let me start off with my point. I'm going to put up two shot charts of Zach LaVine and Devin Booker, and you guys can compare and look at, you know, where their shots are at every spot on the floor, and you'll see that Zach LaVine is better in those areas. Like you said, 42% in front of three-point line, 63% true shooting percentage. Like you said, he's a vicious when he drives to the paint. We've seen him in the dunk contest, those high flying dunks. He's a highlight reel waiting to happen. I mean, but what I like that when he got to Chicago, he's developing in that mid range game. You know, knowing where to. Kind of like Devin Booker. Devin Booker's really good in the mid-range too, but I think Zach LaVine is more effective, he's more efficient, and I think when he gets off that pick and roll or when he gets to the mid-range, he knows how to rise up and, you know, knock down those shots. He takes difficult shots from the three-point line, and I think that Zach LaVine is just really good and really knows how to just put the ball in the basket. And I like that about him. And like you said, everything that you said is very, very true. Now, switching over to Devin Booker, I think, you know, 34% from the league average from the three-point line, not bad. But on catch and shoot threes, 38%, 40%, close to 40% from catch and shoot. That's not bad. But like you said, his bread and butter is definitely that mid-range game, shooting 54% from the 10-foot to 16-foot range. And that's what he does. He gets to that spot, he elevates, and he knocks it down. I mean, can make very contested shots. But I think what Zach LaVine can do in the isolation game, what he can do off the pick and roll, and what he can do getting to the basket, I think it's way better than Devin Booker.
Yeah, and I'd have to agree. And I mean, I don't think there's a great gap between the two. I mean, you could actually probably argue that Devin Booker is a better scorer. I mean, this is a guy that's got the third most points in an individual game in NBA history. Yeah. 71 against the Boston Celtics, even though it was in a loss. But I mean, Devin Booker as a scorer definitely elevated since year two. I mean, this is a guy that, you know, does a really good job picking and choosing his spots within that Phoenix Suns offense. Monty Williams did a phenomenal job, you know, just being able to put the correct guys in the correct lineups. And James Jones, obviously, they did a phenomenal job in, you know, just being able to put the right pieces around Devin Booker. That way he can maximize his offensive capabilities, obviously. And, you know, with Chris Paul playing alongside him, it's a lot easier for him to get off those higher percentage looks. I think he actually has an edge from that perspective. So kind of saddens me that Zach LaVine's actually the better shooter, especially from three, Greg. But, you know, you mentioned from mid-range, obviously, you know, Devin Booker, that's his bread and butter. Very mid-range oriented, like a guy like, Kawhi Leonard. And he's one of the best players from that department in the entire NBA. But I think when you factor in the fact that, you know, he can be a little bit inconsistent in offensively. I know what I'm getting from Zach LaVine from that perspective. And I think even this year, he's gotten off to a much better start in comparison to Devin Booker. I would actually go with Zach LaVine as a better scorer between the two. So, yeah, Zach LaVine takes the edge from that dynamic. But when it comes to playmaking, this is where we start to, you know, see the difference makers. Yeah. Zach LaVine isn't really regarded as a combination guard, I would say, so to speak. I mean, he is capable of, you know, just identifying the open man, so to speak. Not really one of those guys that's going to try to wow you with his passes or anything. Makes a lot of basic reads outside of the pick and roll and maybe playmaking in transition. Isn't really going to be all that effective from this perspective. Or he's not going to have the similar effect to a guy like Devin Booker, I would say, so to speak. But I mean, like you mentioned, I mean, I just think that Devin Booker is probably better from this perspective because he's a little bit more dynamic with his passes. I mean, outside of, you know, pick and pop and, you know, pick and roll scenarios, LaVine kind of absent as a playmaker. And then I think, you know, the fact that, you know, he could improve, you know, just identifying where his guys are at on the floor. A lot of times, you know, he will force up some bad shots. I know a lot of that was given the fact that, you know, he was on a subpar roster last year and he kind of, you know, is trying to, you know, be a little bit better off ball, you know, just making sure that he identifies where guys are when he is on ball and everything. So he's still kind of growing as a combination guard from that perspective. But I would just feel more comfortable going with Devin Booker from this perspective.
Yeah, I don't agree with you with that. I would have to go with Devin Booker as well. But I'm gonna explain the Zach LaVine side because I think Zach LaVine, you know, averaged 5 assists last year, and I think adding the pieces like Lonzo, DeRozan, and then him and Vucevic have really good chemistry. I mean, most of Vucevic's points last year came off assists from Zach LaVine, so he knows how to hit the big and put it right in their hands where they can either get a layup or give it to Vuce on the three-point line where he can knock down a shot. So I like to see that, but I think adding a guy like Lonzo, who is a great cutter off ball, he knows how to attack, he knows how to cut and no back cut, you know, slip off screens and stuff like that to, you know, get himself open off ball. Even Caruso's good too with that. And at the end, having a guy with like DeRozan where you can give him the ball and he can get you assist that way too. So, and having a, you know, versatile guys on our roster like a Derrick Jones, like a Lees Johnson, in transition that you can dump it off to as well. So I see Zach's numbers actually going up this year and where he can, you know, develop in that playmaking end. But like you said, I can see Zach LaVine getting better in that area. But I start off saying Devin Booker, and here's why. I think Devin Booker can actually find the big just like Zach LaVine, but he can also find the guards. You know, when he comes off the screen or if he gets double teamed, he can find the guard. He can make jump passes, one hand passes, skip passes. He's really good in transition, finding his teammates. So I've seen some development out of Devin Booker. I know Zach LaVine hasn't been in that, you know, that point guard type of role that Devin Booker's been in. You know, Zach LaVine kind of got into that role when he got to Chicago, but Devin Booker's really developed his skills over time in Phoenix. So I have to give that edge to Devin Booker, but don't slack on Zach LaVine. I think he will improve his numbers going forward.
Yeah, I mean, as of right now, I would still say Devin Booker's better just because, yeah. I mean, despite, you know, Booker not having, just having better personnel around him up all the way until this point, obviously, I still believe that if you can play make, you're going to be able to play make even at a high level. So with all that being said, I believe Devin Booker's a better playmaker from that perspective. This is a guy that, you know, like you mentioned, a lot more versatile as a passer, can make the skip passes, cross court passes. Really makes a lot of advanced reads. I'm not seeing that so much from Zach LaVine. He's more so basic, like I said, outside of the pick and roll and pick and pop and maybe transition scenarios. I don't really see him, you know, doing too much creation for, you know, guys on that roster. And I think, you know, Devin Booker, he just has better court vision. I think he's probably been able to benefit, you know, having a guy like Chris Paul right next to him, being a mentor, allowing him to, you know, just grow and hear and, you know, take some pointers from Chris Paul when it comes, you know, just identifying how defenses are going to play them, so to speak. So that's probably going to help Devin Booker as a playmaker from that dynamic. And Zach LaVine obviously isn't getting those type of perks. But even despite that, I just think that Devin Booker is just better at identifying guys and, you know, just creating for guys in every dynamic of basketball. But defensively, I think this is another area where we see a noticeable gap. I think Devin Booker, easily is a better defender in comparison to a guy like Zach LaVine. You're talking about a guy that came out of college as a 3-and-D prospect, was compared to Danny Green, and for some reason, once he got to the NBA, he kind of got a bad reputation as a defender. I think playing in Phoenix, somehow, some way, just given the fact that, you know, he was on a bad defensive team that didn't have the right personnel for him to really be able to succeed from that standpoint. Also, given the fact that, you know, just dealing with the overall transition from college to the NBA, so he was going to have his struggles, obviously. But I think, you know, Monty Williams' defensive schemes and their championship mindset definitely going to help only elevate Devin Booker from a defensive perspective. And he's already very effective from this dynamic as of right now. I mean, you're talking about a guy that stays really attentive on a defensive side of the basketball, knows where everyone is at on the floor, and he wants to take on that one-on-one matchup. You know, I see that from LaVine in close moments and in times where, you know, the game needs to be won in a clutch and everything. But over the course of a 48-minute game, I'm not seeing Zach LaVine guard a Paul George and, you know, other perimeter threats like that. And Devin Booker, I have to give him, you know, the edge because of that. And also, given the fact that, you know, he has a team that, you know, could easily put, you know, a Cam Johnson or a Mikal Bridges on guys like that, but he's taking on the challenge to take on those defensive assignments, and I'm just not seeing that out of Zach LaVine right now. So I would actually go with Devin Booker as a better defender.
Yeah, I would have to go with Devin Booker as well. I think he can guard better one-on-one. He can play off ball. He, you know, he uses his length and his body to be aggressive with the guards. But I don't, Zach LaVine statistically, his defensive rating and his, you know, all the analytics, deep analytics on defense are actually going up just slightly. But what I've been watching is his off ball. You know, he's getting better, you know, getting around screens, because he was terrible with that with the film that I've watched. Really, defense for me, it's about giving effort. So if Zach LaVine can just really buy in, especially with the guys they brought in, guys like Lonzo, guys like Caruso, and those, even, I mean, I know Patrick Williams is out, but he's not bad. He wasn't bad in defensively at college either. So having those guys around him who can, you know, challenge him and get him to buy in on the defensive end, at least every possession. I know he needs to save his energy for offense, but if they can get him to buy in on the defensive end, I think he can grow in that area. But I think Devin Booker right now is better than him, just because he's more versatile on the defensive end, and he can do more on that side of the basketball.
Yeah, and I would agree with that. And obviously, you know, I think with all that being said, if we're tying in the fact that, you know, from a scoring perspective, despite, you know, Zach LaVine getting the slight edge from me, I think Devin Booker's just as good from that dynamic. And then when I tie in the fact that, you know, I would believe that Devin Booker's a better playmaker and a better defender overall, I would say that Devin Booker probably is a more impactful player and is a better player between him and Zach LaVine, obviously. But Greg, what is your thoughts on that?
I see where you're coming from, but I got to get the slight edge of Zach LaVine. What I've seen these past two seasons, I've seen a lot of growth in his game, especially on the scoring end. I see the playmaking potentially going up with the guys around him. He actually has some good complementary pieces around him. And then the defensively, I think he could get better at that. He just has to, you know, understand the personnel, understand where guys need to be on the defensive end, and I think his defensive IQ would get better. He just needs to use his length and his size and really just be in the film room to get that area right. But I think Zach LaVine going forward, so to see the progression to where he started, I think right now we got to give, especially after last year season, all this historic numbers, I have to give the edge. Slight edge to Zach LaVine.
Well, we'll let you guys debate it out in the comment section. Thank y'all so much for tuning in to another episode with me and Greg on the Ball Fake Podcast. If you're new to our YouTube channel, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on post notifications. And if you're listening on Apple Podcasts or Spotify, make sure to give us a 5-star rating and a nice little review. But besides that, it's your boy, Nicey Chung of Benny. I'm here with my co-host, Greg King, and we out.
We out.